Hi friends, in this session we are going to discuss about file system. So by definition, a file is a named collection of related information that is recorded on secondary storage. Okay, a file contains certain information that should be recorded or stored in secondary storage. Generally we write something on notepad and save it as one file. We call it as a normal text file. We write a prepare a document or a letter in Word and save it as a document file. So like that you can generate different files based on the application you are using. But by definition, in general, a file is a collection of related information. Finally, it should be stored in a secondary storage. Now, file types. So there are so many file types available. File means it's not a single type, it is of different types. Suppose you are created a normal text, that file is called a text file. That should be understandable by the humans. Okay, if a file contains some programming code, some definition, some functions, some modules, that kind of file is called a source file. Generally, the program written in C language, Java language, Python, etc., those files are called source files. Okay, you can understand, but it cannot execute directly. Those such type of files are called source files. And next one is object file. So object file cannot understand by humans. It consists of bytecode, series of bytes or blocks of bytes. It can be understandable by system's linker only. Okay, so the file is called object file. It cannot be understandable by the humans. Only the computer understands. In computer specifically, linker can understand the object file. And the final one is executable file. Executable file means a file. In general, if you observe in Windows operating system, for some files, if you double click on the file itself runs. That kind of files are called executable files. Okay, so the executable files also you cannot open that files, you cannot see the code in the file, and only the operating system understand the code available in the file. Okay, so I am taking one C program as an example, and I can classify what are the text file in at what part it's a text file, at what it's a source file, object file and executable file. Suppose you are generating one C file, or you are writing a C program and name it as demo.c. So by using any editor, and you save it in some storage location, C drive or D drive. So your file is stored in the secondary storage device, and the file consists of certain information. By definition, it is a file. Now what kind of file it is? It is a normal source file. It is not a text file. Text file contains only human understandable data. Even though the program understandable by the human, but not all the humans understand the programming language. Which learn the programming language, those people are understanding. Okay, so a C program consists of header files, some functions, and main function is there. Okay, so it consists of the functions and subroutines. So you can call it as a source file. Now demo.c is a source file. Okay, when you compile this program, in the compilation there are different stages: linking stage and loading stage. At the time of linking, what happens if your file having any header files inclusion, or if you call any methods which are already defined, those will be expanded and that code will be included into your program. Now your program is converted into machine understandable format. That file is called object file. Okay, so the linker software handles this part. That means the linker software links all the modules information into your existing source file. Now the file is called object file. Coming into the executable file, once the linker finishes its task, now the loader gets the code and load it into primary memory for execution. So that file is called executable file. Okay, I think you should you can easily understand this example. So generally file types are classified into text file, source file, object file, executable file. Okay, so next, file attributes. So every file contains certain attributes for identification purpose. Properties or attributes, we can say that. So every file contains attributes. So here, see, the first attribute is name. So the by using the name, a person can easily understand the file. Okay, so it's a human readable form. The name is human readable form. Suppose you are generating one text file, you are giving sample. So sample is my file name. You are generating a letter by using MS Word. You are giving the name letter. Okay, by name you can easily understandable which file is, that is called name. Okay, next, identifier. Identifier means it is automatically generated number, unique tag identifies file within file system. So the file system and the operating system automatically generates one number and assign it to the file you generated. That is called identifier. A normal user cannot see the identifier information. Next, type. So type means, already we discussed earlier, which type of file, whether it should be a text file or an object file or an executable file. Okay, this tells the type. How you can identify the type means, so a normal user identifies a file by using the name, but an operating system identifies the file by using type. How can it identify type? By using the extension. See, a normal text file having an extension .txt, if you generate a text file by using Notepad or some other text editor, the file having the extension .txt, an image file having the extension .jpeg. There are so many extensions. A source file having an extension .c, .c++, .java, like that. So operating system understands the file by using the extension. Okay, that is the type. And location. After generating the file, you should save that file, definitely. So the location means it is a pointer variable to the file location. So when you invoke the file, operating system generates a system call. That system calls get the pointer. So the pointer having the information of the location of the file. By using the location, it easily identifies the file. Size. So every file contains data, so definitely every file should occupy certain memory. That tells the size. And protection. Protection means you are generating a file, but you generate a file in such a way that the other people read that file only. Those people cannot edit, cannot update. Or you generate a file in such a way so you can read, you can update, also other users also can read and update. So you can set the permissions for the file, whether the file is readable or whether the file is writable. Okay, and next one is time, date and user identification. So these are also for security purpose. When the file was generated, on which time it was generated, on which time it was updated, on which date it was generated, which time it has accessed, and user identification. In computer, there are so many users using the computer. So which user opens the file, which user update the file, which user access the file. This tells the time, date and user identification. So like that, these are in general attributes. In addition to that, the file system generate directory structure for accessing the file. means you are saving the file. For example, you are saving your file in your folder. That folder is available in some disk drive. So now what is the exact location of your file? First you have to go to the particular drive, then go to the particular folder, then access your file. So this is called structure. Okay, this structure was generated by the file system to easily identify the files. So these are the file attributes available. Okay, next, file operations. So what are the operations, what are the tasks you are going to perform on the file are called file operations. In general, file operations are you are creating a file, you are writing a file, you are opening a file, okay, you are updating the file. So like that, there are so many operations for every file. We know, we already generate one file and you open the file by using open command or open dialog box. After some open the any file, you write something, that is called writing the file. While you creating the file, you simply open the application where you generate the file, then you save the file. That is also one type of creating. Now we will understand what happens when you creating a file, when you are writing a file or opening a file in operating system point of view. So you know how you can open a notepad file, how you can save a notepad file, or how you can open a C editor and create a file, how you can edit any C program, you know. But we discussed what happened when you create a file internally. What happened when you writing something on the file? Okay, in operating system perspective, so what are the operations? Okay, first we will see creating a file. Creating a file is used to create a file. First, if you want to generate any file, you have to open the application and type something and give the name. So here you observe, it requires two basic steps. First, to find space for file in file system, and next is to make entry in directory for this file. So actually this first step has handled by the operating system, it is not the job of the user. First, to find space for file. Suppose you are simply copying one file from your pen drive, or you are downloading a file, it is also creating a file. So then the operating system estimate the first the operating system identifies how much memory is occupied by the file which you are creating, and that much of memory is available or not. If that much of memory is available, then it asks the user for selecting the directory. Then you can choose the directory and you can give the name or something. Then you are giving the name and the location, automatically that file was generated. That means when you are creating a file, the operating system identifies how much memory reserved for this file. Even it is an empty file, it should definitely reserve some memory. So that is job of the operating system. We don't bother about it. We have to give the name and you have to choose the location of the file only. That is about the creating a file. Next, coming to the writing a file. Writing a file, definitely suppose you are writing any content to the file, definitely that file should be created earlier. Okay, so you have to open the file, then you have to write something on the file. Okay, so how can you open the file? By using the name of the file and by giving the directory of the file. Then the operating system open that file, and operating system maintains the pointer to the location where you write. That is called write pointer. Suppose you are writing something, you are typing a line, then press enter, then your write pointer is pointing to the next line. So whatever you are entering, those data will be stored in the second line or the next line of the file. So that is the job of the operating system. Okay, so next, reading a file. So reading a file means already you are created a file, you open the file and you read the file. Just imagine a file contains some 10 pages. All the 10 pages are not visible at a time. Or the file contains, or a text file contains some 100 lines. All the 100 lines are not visible on a computer screen. Okay. Now operating system set a read pointer. Set a read pointer, that pointer is updated. That pointer is updated. You are scrolling the scroll bar. Suppose you are reading one line, you are going to the next line. Always read pointer is updated. Read pointer is updated so that the user can visible the readable line on the computer screen. So that is job of the operating system while you reading a file. Next one is repositioning within a file. Repositioning within a file means already you generated a file, already you typed something on the file, but if you want to replace the positions of the text, suppose you are entering two paragraphs in a file. Now there is a need to change the first paragraph, move to the second position, and the second paragraph move to the first position. You are simply repositioning. Repositioning file doesn't involve any I/O operations. Okay, so the content will be same, the memory will be same. Simply you are repositioning. It needs the seek operation. So the seek operation, in the sense, your header, hard disk header pointing. So the first pointing the area of the text, you are repositioning. Okay. Next, deleting a file. So deleting a file means you are simply removing the reference or pointer variable. So you know there is a pointer variable which identifies the location of the file. So you are simply removing the address in the pointer variable. Then the file will be removed. Okay. So the file will be removed, in the sense, definitely you will get some extra space. Whatever the space occupied by the file, that was already removed, and you will get some extra space. Okay. Suppose your computer is occupying with some junk files. If you delete all these files, definitely you will get the more space. That is the deleting file. Next, truncating a file. Truncating a file means it is not deleting the file, but deleting the content available in the file. Suppose you are creating some demo.txt file. That file consists of two paragraphs of text. Okay. Now, if you after opening the file, if you select the two paragraphs and simply delete the text, that is called truncating the file. Or if you delete the complete file, that is deleting a file. That is the difference between deleting file and truncating a file. Next, open a file. So open a file means definitely that file already stored, and by using the open dialog box in Windows operating system, you select the directory, you are giving the file name, then you will get the file. You can able to see that file. That means your operating system, after selecting your directory and file name, it checks all the attributes and it checks the memory address based on the pointer variable. It gets the location of the file and it opens, then you can able to see that file. Okay. Sorry. So these are the file operations: creating a file, writing a file, reading a file, repositioning within a file, deleting a file, truncating a file, open a file. Okay. Now these are the examples of the different files, file types, and their extensions and their functions. Already we discussed earlier, there are different types of files: text files, source files, object files, executable files. Okay. So here you observe executable files, object files, source code files. In addition to that, batch files, text files, word processor files, library files, multimedia files. If you take executable file, executable files definitely having different extensions. So you know every file having extensions. Based on these extensions, operating system understands which type of the file it is. So executable file having the extensions .exe or exe, com, bin, etc. So you take Windows operating system, exe and com are the executable files. In Unix or Linux operating systems, bin and etc are the executable files. So what is the function of these executable files? Read to run machine language program. Read to run machine language program means already the program is converted into machine understandable format. If you click or double click on these files, automatically the file starting the execution. That means the operating system execute the machine language program. Okay, next, object files. Object files having extension obj, o, class, etc. So these files are compiled machine language, not linked. So these are converted into machine language and these files are compiled and but not linked. Okay, next, source code. So all the most of the programming language files are called source code files. Those are in various languages. Next, batch files. Batch files having extensions BAT, BAT, SH. So these are the commands given to the interpreter. So BAT, in DOS operating system you can generate a batch file with extension BAT. In Windows, in Unix or Linux operating system, you write a shell script with an extension .ch, sh. These are the commands to the command interpreter. Next, text files. Normal text files which are in human understandable format, having extensions txt, doc. So notepad files are txt files and document files doc. Maybe some word processors having doc files. And separate word processor files, WP, TEX, PDF, RRT, again DOC, etc. So these are the extensions of different word processor files. So in Windows operating system, we are using Microsoft Word. So for Microsoft Word, DOC is the extension, DOC or DOCX. And if you are using some WordPad, RRT is the format, rich text format, PDF, personal document format, portable document format. These are all coming under the category of word processor files. Next, library files. Library files having the extension lib, a, so and dll. These files contains the routines of the programs. Routines means functions. Functions without main. Suppose you take C program. C program having generally main function. If you are generating a file having C code, it consists of only the methods but doesn't contain main. You can say that it is a library file. Library file. So like that DLL file, dynamic link library. These files are not self-executable but it contains some methods to execute. Next, multimedia files. So multimedia files contains audio and video information. So the extensions are MPEG, MOV, RM. So these are the common file types you are using in different programming languages, different operating systems, Windows or Unix or some other operating systems. So every file has certain extension. Based on this extension only your operating system identify the type of the file. Okay, so thank you for this session.